glimpses,
highlight.
Okay, something. Glimpse. So you got a glimpse of her dress before she finally entered the venue. Yeah, a hint, you know, like a small view of it, right? So, right, why a glimpse of India? We're just talking about these three short stories or these three short write-ups about India. And it is just going to give us a little brief idea about it. So, because our country is so vast, right? So, what is it, you know, like here? Yes, that makes our country so beautiful. It's diversity, right? What makes us so diverse? Can you give an example of diversity? Different cultures? Yes. Different festivals, different cultures, traditions, right? Even right from the way we speak, the way, you know, like, yes, dressing up, everything here, from one state to another, there's variation. And that is what makes us so different, so diverse, and yet so beautiful. Right? So in this diversity, there is that togetherness. Is there really that togetherness? Why not? Yeah, Amritpal is shaking his head. Why not? Why not that togetherness? This is very, very important here to discuss. Equality nahi hai. We're talking about here, if I talk about, you know, like people from the West and the South and the North and the East, so they all have their different attires, their different language, different festivals they celebrate. And do we accept them all? Why do we have a problem in acceptance? What is there that does not make us accept this difference? It's our ignorance, isn't it? Because we are not aware that in spite of the differences in their appearances and all the differences that we have, we still belong to the same country. And it is this diversity that makes us so beautiful. And we should be proud of it. We should accept here. Like, what is our opinion about people from the Northeast? How much do we know about them? They're tribal, that's it. End of story. What else? What else? What else do we know about them? Tea plantation, okay. Yeah, we're talking about Assam. Yes? Least populated? Yes, educated. Northeasterns are not, they are, right? Okay, yes. What else? So see here, okay, so what is it when you talk about the Northeast? We talk about Manipur and Nagaland, Assam and Mizoram and Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim. What is it that immediately comes to our mind when you think about them? Talk about appearance. What do we think about? What about appearance? Come on, say it. Small eyes. Okay, right. Chinese look. Are they Chinese? No, they're not. What else do we think about them? That, yeah, they have, you know, like maybe with a spear in hand and they go chasing animals, they're tribals, is it? They keep on doing that the whole day, right? And we think about them, you know, like, okay, they do the bamboo dance, is it? All day, it's what a jingalala dance, is it? No, it's not. There is much more to that, right? Sikkim has been there, when you talk about it, one of the cleanest states, right? And it is soon going to be one that is going to stop the sale of packaged drinking water. Do we know this? No, we don't. Because we think they just eat the noodles and the momos and that's it the whole day, right? There's much more to their life than that, okay? Right? So we need to learn about them. Why don't we learn about them? Because we don't want to. Right? And by chance, supposing, like, of course, we are not then better than Peggy or Maddie then if, right, a Northeastern student comes to our class. How easy is it going to be to accept him or her? No, it's going to be difficult. What about South India? What is our opinion about South India? Come on, let's hear it today. Yes? They love to eat rice. Even Northeast people, they love to eat rice. Right? And they have different colors. They have different varieties of rice. You know, it's not only the white rice. They have a black rice and a sticky rice over there. Right? So, yes? What? Plate use nahi karte South India. They save so much. And we have the steel industry so famous from South. Right? So we talk about, when you talk about steel utensils and all, we talk about Tamil Nadu. Right? What else do we know about South India? Okay, they love to eat rice. They don't have plates, poor thing. Right? What else? Yes? Rainfall is more over there. What else? Yes? What do they do? White color ka paint lagate. Wow. What? So it is their culture and tradition, you know, like, of course, they're very religious people. They are highly educated, definitely no doubt about it. But in spite of that, you know, they are still very close to their culture. Right? So what about the dances of South India? Are you aware of them? Kathakali is there, you have Bharatnatyam is there, isn't it? Right? Oh, yeah, so you have Mohiniyattam, all these dances are there, right? Okay, let's come to the West now. Okay, let's talk about Gujarat and all, right? What about them? What do they do then? What do they keep on eating? What do they keep on eating? They jalebi and papada, thank God to Tarak Mehta, is it? Yes, silence. What else? What else? They do their garba. Okay, they always, they have these sticks ready. Whenever they feel happy, they do their garba. Is it? Yes. Okay, what else? Business-minded people. Okay, right. What else? Tribes. Yeah, what? Yes, so Jaipur there, we talk about the Pink City. We talk about Rajasthan, the forts, the palaces, and the beautiful, rich culture heritage here. Okay, let's come to North here. Let's talk about us. Sarson ka saag. Okay. Makki ki roti ya bhangra. You know, like, what do you think if somebody else, you know, had to describe us, you know, about Punjabis and all? What would they say? Just like you are talking, you know, like, okay, they have these small eyes and they put that white paint. What are they going to talk about Punjabis? Oh, they are having the aloo ke paranthas and sarso ka saag and lassi the whole day. Is it? Right? And yeah, like, of course, they are so brand conscious that they don't talk below their Gucci and Prada and all that stuff. Isn't it? Right? So big show offs, Punjabi, yeah, that is what the people think about us. They've learned it, no? That's nice. So you can also reply in Gujarati. It will sound so nice, isn't it? Right? Yeah. So why don't we think it that we've got an opportunity to learn so much? And we should be proud of all this, right? So once again here, we have to, what about here? We're going to start with the bakers of Goa. What about Goa? What do you think about Goa? Beaches, okay. Mother, full on holiday season, isn't it? Everyone is in holiday mood always, right? Let's go to the beach. Is it? Yes? So no one studies over there? No, they don't study. They just play the guitar and go walk along the beach. Is it? That's it? Yes? They're always allowed. They're always in the casual dress. Okay, right. So that's also. See, like here, just by this little discussion, we have come to know that we don't know anything about India. Right? There is so much that we need to learn. Right? So we have to learn about our history, about our culture, about our traditions. And, you know, like, of course, I should not be sharing personal experiences, but this is something that I really want to share. So when it comes to Northeast, right, when I was in my university days, I had a friend, she was from Manipur, and I'm still friends with her. And she did not go around, you know, over there in the streets, you know, chasing anybody or anything like that. Okay, generally we think about the Nagamese people, you know, like, yeah, they are there, they eat anything that moves, That is generally what, except the table and the chair maybe, right? That is there. So I got an opportunity many years ago to go to Nagaland, right? Here, they are, of course, very educated people. They're very religious people. Most important thing, the cleanliness over there. They are there. Yes, they're modern, yet very, very traditional. They have not moved away. And from Nagaland, when you talk about Nagaland, you know, they eat so much of variety of animals, you know. So whether it is about snails or it's about frogs, right, or a snake or things like that, you know. So there's a special market of all this. You can't stand there for a minute over there in that market. You go to Kohima, right, or other places there, or all the cities of. So this special market, and maybe for a minute you can't even stand there. And you have people coming out from these big cars, and they buy snails and frogs and things, right? It's a part of their culture. That is how they have, you know, grown up and all. And yes, Nagaland is very famous for its tribes, and there's a festival which is held, the Hornbill Festival. All the tribes, they come together, right? So here, of course, when you talk about South, yes, I was there during my school days. I always made sure I had a South Indian friend so that we could exchange our tiffins, you know. So she would love my parathas, and I could have her idli and all. Right. So, and of course, South Indians are not like that, only that they put that paint and they do the Kathakali the whole day. No, they are very, very focused people. It is that we people keep on sharing everything and all of that. They are there, very determined, very focused. That way, of course, even we are, but we have our stereotype of thinking about them. Maybe they also have like that, isn't it? Right? And they think that, okay, you come from Punjab, it's such a rich state and all that and things like that. So you have the right to behave the way you do. So what I'm saying is that let us come out of these shells that we have built around ourselves and realize that, yes, we should appreciate the beauty of our country. Let us appreciate the diversity. Let us learn inclusion. We don't want to end up like Maddie or Peggy, right? Just because my name is different, my appearance is different, my culture is different, my festivals are different, right? So we have to come out of this narrow-minded thinking, right? So maybe this is why here, of course, in this chapter, it does not talk much about you can say culture and all, but it is, they're talking about, yeah, we missed about one thing about Punjabis. We love Canada more. Yes, Canada dream and America dream, isn't it, that we have, is it? Yeah, so somewhere or the other, we do have that. Yes, so right. Now let's start with a baker from Goa. It's a very nice, what you can say, extract, right? Beautifully written, and you're going to really enjoy it. Okay, a baker from Goa. Now, when you think about Goa, we've discussed, right? What about bakers? We love going to the bakery. Yes, right? So what's our favorite bakery product? Cakes, right? Yeah. Yeah, chocolate truffle cake. Okay, right. So we have there, we love going there, and yes, cake here. And Goa, it has a great foreign influence. Can you tell which foreign influence Goa has? We were there, India was ruled by the Britishers. There were other countries also, right? Which foreign influence does Goa have? Anybody? Portuguese. Very good. He's read the first line and now he's telling me the answer. Okay, good. Right, yes, Ruf. Okay, yeah. So our elders are often heard reminiscing nostalgically about those good old Portuguese days. Good old Portuguese days. What does that mean? We all talk about the good old days, about the past, and things were much better and happier. You know, life was much easier. Right? So Portuguese influence, yes, Goa has a great Portuguese influence. And what about the French influence? Where do you think the French influence is seen in India? Have you heard about Pondicherry, Puducherry? Yes, so the French influence is greatly seen over there, right? So these two states have this very dominant presence over there. They show that foreign influence. The Portuguese and their famous loaves of bread. So when the Portuguese came, they brought along with them their baking, right? Their bread. Those eaters of loaves might have vanished, but the makers are still there. Who do you think is there? The eaters of loaves? The Portuguese? But the makers now in Goa, right? The Indians who are there. We still have among us the mixers, the molders, and those who bake the loaves. So if you have baked a cake, you know there is a lot of things that you have to do, right? So the mixing is there. And you put it in the mold and then it goes into the oven, right? Those age-old time-tested furnaces still exist. So you go to Goa, it's not necessarily that you have these ovens. So they still have the traditional method of baking, right? So furnaces where these breads were baked, so the loaves were baked. The fire in the furnaces has not yet been extinguished and it should never be extinguished. So the fire is still there, it's still burning, right? Because yes, so baking is still going on, it's carried on. The thud and jingle of the traditional baker's bamboo heralding his arrival in the morning can still be heard in some places. So like earlier, right? How did the baker announce his arrival? He had this bamboo and there were these bells. And as he would come, he would thump it and the bells would jingle. So, right, so the baker would announce his arrival by the jingling and the thumping of the bamboo. So in some places, it is still there. That tradition is still alive. And how wonderful it must be. You know, little things that have been lost with the passage of time. So if we still have those traditions, yes, it would be very nice, beautiful. Maybe the father is not alive, but the son still carries on the family profession. And, you know, like with modern times, with the passage of time, many traditions are lost. But if those traditions are they carried on, I think so, they're still valued a lot by people. So this little tradition here that the baker had in the earlier times, nowadays we have bakeries at every, you know, like, of course, street there. Earlier, it was not such. So there were a few furnaces and in the morning, the baker would come with his fresh loaves of bread and now would he tell, I'm coming with the jingle, the thud of the bamboo. Okay, the stick, he would announce his arrival. These bakers are even today known as Pedar in Goa. So what are the bakers called? Pedar. Okay, right? Now, during our childhood in Goa, the baker used to be our friend, companion, and guide. So the baker was there, very important. He used to come at least twice a day. Once when he set out in the morning on his selling around, and then again when he returned after emptying his huge basket. So twice he would hear him. Once in the morning when he would come with all his bread and all the goods, he would go around. Then when he'd come with his empty basket. So he was a part of the childhood. He was a part of the growing up years. Okay. The jingling thud of his bamboo woke us up from sleep and we ran to meet and greet him. Why was it so? Was it for the love of the loaf? What is the love of the loaf? Was it for the bread that they would go running to meet him? Not at all. The loaves were bought by some Baskin or Bastin, the maid servant of the house. So they did not buy, right? The youngsters did not buy. The children did not buy. That was done by the maids. The other servants were there. Then why did they go running when the baker came? If it was not for buying bread, what was it for? What we longed for were those bread bangles, which we chose carefully. Sometimes it was sweet bread of special make. So what do you think is a bread bangle? Yes? Yeah, gold bread, round bread, like a bangle, right? So they would maybe make those specially for children. And so they were not worried about that how many loaves of bread the house required. they were more worried about that they should not miss out on the bread bangles or sometimes a particular quality of cake that the baker would carry. Now, can anyone tell me about the arrival of the baker? How did the baker announce his arrival? How would he announce his arrival? Yes, by the jingling and the thudding of the bamboos, right? Yes. And what are bakers known in Goa? Pedal. Okay, so right, we know about the different varieties of cake, right? Do you think there are special cakes for special occasions? Or is it the same you can make for any occasion? Yes, are they? Are they? Nowadays we have a lot. Earlier also there was there, right? So have you heard about the Christmas cake, the Christmas pudding? Yes. So what about, and it's very famous, Goa, you know, like the Christmas cake there, that pudding is very, very famous. So it starts maybe so many weeks before Christmas, you know, they start soaking the dry fruits in liquor and then afterwards that cake is made. So that very particular taste and that particular quality. Okay. Now, the baker made his musical entry on the scene with a jang jang, sound of his specially made bamboo staff. What is jang jang? The sound. What do we call a word that replicates a sound? What do we call a word that replicates a sound? You just said it, somebody said it correctly. Yes, onomatopoeia or onomatopoeia, whatever, right? So we have words like this. What is buzz? What is hiss? Crash? All these are sounds, that the words that replicate the sound. So jang, jang, the sound made by the bamboos. And who made that? The baker. One hand supported the basket on his head. And the other banged the bamboo on the ground. So it would be a very typical scene here. On one hand, there he's supporting the basket. And on the other, he had his bamboo stick. And he's coming and announcing his arrival. He would greet the lady of the house with good morning. And then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. We kids would be pushed aside with a mild rebuke. And the loaves would be delivered to the servant. But we would not give up. We refer to the children. Yes. We would climb a bench or the parapet and peep into the basket. Somehow, I can still recall the typical fragrance of those loaves. And when a cake is being baked, you know, at home, what about that aroma, you know, that fragrance it comes? It's very tempting. Yes. We can't wait for the cake to cool down. Yeah, so it's a very tempting fragrance, isn't it? That aroma that comes there. So they were there, of course, and fresh bread. It has a very lovely, yes. So we would climb a bench or the parapet and peep into the basket. Somehow, I can still recall the typical fragrance of those loaves. Loaves for the elders and the bangles for the children. So what did the children wait for? Like, was it their responsibility to buy the bread? No, they waited for the bread bangles. Yes. Then we did not even care to brush our teeth or wash our mouths properly. And why should we? Who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush? And why was it necessary at all? The tiger never brushed his teeth. So why should they? Right? And especially when you have these bread bangles in front of you. Who has the time to brush teeth? Thought tea could wash and clean up everything so nicely after all. So they have the bread bangles and then they have hot tea and the teeth would be clean. Now Punjabi, maybe they can't wait to brush their teeth. Early morning, they need their morning tea. Okay. Yes, yeah, so this chapter, it is going to be very tempting. You know, even though it's nice that you have your break after this. Right. Okay. I'll come to the questions, but let's move to the next part. Let's finish the reading, then we'll come to the questions. Marriage gifts are meaningless without the sweet bread known as the ball. Just as a party or a feast loses its charm without bread. Not enough can be said to show how important a baker can be for a village. So marriages functions incomplete without bread. And of course, the particular bread here, special sweet bread, what was it called? The ball. The lady of the house must prepare sandwiches on the occasion of her daughter's engagement. So there were sandwiches in the time of an engagement and of course, special breads in the time of the marriage. Cakes and bulinas. So bulina is also kind of a sweet bread, right? Are a must for Christmas as well as other festivals. Thus, the presence of the baker's furnace in the village is absolutely essential. So, right, the daily routine is incomplete without the baker. Family functions, marriages, they are incomplete. So the baker was a very important part of the society, right? Yes. The baker or bread seller of those days had a peculiar dress known as the kabai. So what did the baker wear? What was the dress called? It was called the kabai. It was a single piece long frock reaching down to the knees. In our childhood, we saw bakers wearing a shirt and trousers which were shorter than full length ones and longer than half pants. So of course, traditionally, what would the baker wear? He would wear this long frock, you know, like yes, and that was called as the kabai. But with the passage of time, they started wearing shirt and trouser, but the trouser was not the long one like you wear. And it was somewhere mid-calf, lower than the knee, but higher than the ankle. Okay, right. Even today, anyone who wears a half pant, which reaches just below the knees, invites the comment that he is dressed like a peder. So even now in Goa, people are there who dress like that. They are called as peder. And what's a peder in the language? A baker. The baker usually collected his bills at the end of the month. So the whole month he would come and give the loaves, and at the end of the month he would do his calculations, right? Monthly accounts used to be recorded on some wall in pencil. See, so much faith they had. It was on the wall that he would record. He did not have all these registers, or he had an accountant or something like that, you know, to take care. Baking was indeed a profitable profession in the old days. The baker and his family never starved. How could they? When they were baking all these loaves and breads. Right? He, his family, and his servants always looked happy and prosperous. Their plump physique was an open testimony to this. Even today, any person with a jackfruit-like physical appearance is easily compared to a baker. So bakers were considered to be healthy and plump, right? They were never starved. And even now, two things here. One is if someone wears his trousers, which is just below the knees, or someone is very plump, you know, like, of course, so like that jackfruit, okay? So that person is considered to be a baker because they're not skinny and they're not malnourished. They are not at all, what you can say, thin, okay? So we have read one part. Was it difficult? It's nice, interesting. Yes, so we've read about the different kinds of breads. We've talked about, yes. So who brought this art of baking to Goa? Who brought this? Who brought the loaves? Portuguese, right. What do you think India has given to the world? If we talk about here, you know, like, yes, spices India has given, yes. And in fact, that is how you can say yes. What else spices and you people can tell me much better. Yes, cotton, very nice, very good. Cotton was there, right? So silk also coming from. So from India also and from, right? You talk about the silk route, isn't it? In China also. Okay, so yeah, so when you talk about India, we talk about spices, we talk about cotton. All this is definitely with what the world has got from. Right? Okay. So we'll end over here today and continue